Hi, welcome to Mrs. Moskowitz's Art Room. I'd like to share a book with you today about the artist we've been learning about, Paul Cezanne. It's called Cezanne and the Apple Boy by Laurence Anholy. Paul was playing with his friends when his mother brought him a letter. "Look," she said, "it's from your father." Paul had not seen his father in a long time, and he knew that his father was an artist who lived far away in the countryside. And Paul had exactly the same name as his father. It was written on all of his school books, Paul Cezanne. Paul read the letter. "Dear Paul, I would like you to visit me. The countryside is beautiful. I think you are old enough to come on a painting expedition in the mountains. With love, from your father, Paul Cezanne." Then something fell out of the envelope. It was a train ticket. His mother packed some food in a little bag. She put him on the train and kissed him goodbye. It was a long journey, and the motion of the train put Paul to sleep. When he woke up, he saw a mountain. Paul walked out of the station and into the little town. At last, he found his father's house, but there was no one home.
"I'll tell you where you'll find him," said a lady, "halfway up the mountain, painting crazy pictures."
So Paul stepped onto the winding path, which led out of town and into the mountains. It was very hot, and the path was steep. In the shade of a tree, a donkey was munching apples. Someone was talking to himself nearby. Paul peeped around the corner.
"Oh," he shouted. High on a rocky path, he saw a man as big as a bear. He was making a wild painting, and he had a shaggy beard and wild eyes. Paul ran back down the path. "Paul, Paul, don't you remember? I am Paul Cezanne, the same as you. I am your father."
Cezanne was as big as the mountain, but he spoke gently. "I'm very pleased to see you," he said, "but I will not shake your hand. You see, I don't like anyone touching me." Then the mountain man picked up his paints and set off along the path. "We are going on a journey right to the top of the Blue Mountain," said Cezanne. "It's a long way, but if we follow the path, we won't get lost. We haven't got much money, but look, we have plenty of apples, plenty of paints and canvases. You look after the donkey, and I'll look after you." When it grew dark, they built a fire by a little stream. "Tomorrow, I will paint a picture of you," said Cezanne, "but you will have to sit as still as an apple." Then they fell asleep under the stars. When Paul woke up, Cezanne was sorting his paintings. "You see, Paul," he said, "I am inventing a new kind of painting. I make everything into simple shapes. I paint houses like boxes and trees like cones. Everything has a shape."
"What shape am I?" asked Paul.
"You are as round as a sweet little apple." They followed the winding path through a valley and into a dusty village. The people in the cafe stared at Cezanne and laughed at his pictures.
"Ha, what have you painted today?" they snorted. "A crooked house or a wobbly tree?"
"You see, Paul," his father sighed, "the world doesn't understand me, and I don't understand the world. That's why I spend my time in the mountains."
"And that's why you're so poor, mountain man," laughed the people in the cafe.
Cezanne stood up and walked toward the door.
"Huh, just a moment," said a voice behind him. "May I see that picture?"
Paul turned around. A man with a bow tie and expensive suit was staring at his painting.
"This is extraordinary," he said. "I would like to take this picture back to my art gallery in the city. My name is Villard, and I am an art dealer, and I am always looking for exciting new work."
"Well, we have more paintings than we can carry," said Cezanne. "Take as many as you like. Have this one and this one and this one and this one." So Villard left with a huge pile of paintings. Paul ran after him.
"Please, Mr. Villard," he whispered, look after these paintings. I think they are very special. I think my father has invented a new kind of painting. Then Paul helped his father pack up his paints as they walked out of the dusty village. They could hear the people laughing. Oh, Paul, said Cezanne, sometimes life is as hard as climbing a mountain. People are right. My paintings are worth nothing at all. At last, there was no money left. I should find a job, said Cezanne. The trouble is, I'm only good at one thing, and that's painting. I know something else you are good at, said Paul quietly. You are good at being a father. In the distance, Paul saw a tiny man waving his arms and shouting. When he came closer, Paul could see that the man was dressed in an expensive suit with a bow tie. It was Villard. Quick, Paul, he panted. Where's your father? My father is working, said Paul. If you want to buy a painting, you will have to talk to me. Villard laughed. Listen, he said, everyone in Paris is talking about the mountain man. They say he has invented a new kind of painting. Oh, of course, said Paul. My father is the greatest painter in the world. What's all this noise? Asked Cezanne, coming around the corner. I'm trying to explain, said Villard. I have sold every one of your paintings. All this money is for you. I want to buy more, as many as you can paint. Cezanne stuffed the money in his pocket. Thank you very much, Mr. Villard. I would like to shake your hand, but you see, I don't like anybody touching me. Now, if you will excuse me, Paul and I have to leave. We are nearly at the top of our mountain. Sometimes life is hard, said Cezanne, but you follow your path. And at last you reach the top, shouted Paul. Then Paul and his father walked back down the mountain. When they reached the dusty village, Paul was afraid that the people would laugh, but he held himself high. I am the son of the mountain man, he whispered. The summer was ending and the apple trees were golden brown. At last they reached the little town and there was Cezanne's house near the station. Paul ran so fast he almost knocked over his mother, who was waiting to take him home. Oh, Paul, she said, I hardly recognized you. You have grown so tall. Well, Paul, said his father, we had a good expedition. I would like to shake your hand, but I will give you a big kiss instead, said Paul. When Paul got back to the city, he ran outside to see his friends. He didn't notice, but something fell from his pocket, a tiny apple seed. 10 years passed, and Paul looked outside where the tiny seed had grown into an apple tree, which blossomed in the spring. He thought of his father, Paul Cezanne, following his path high on the Blue Mountain. He had become a successful art dealer like Villard. He sold his father's paintings all over the world, and people paid millions of dollars for the paintings of mountains, crooked houses, and piles of apples on wobbly tables. And that's the story of Cezanne and the Apple Boy. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you'll join me again for next week's program. And I hope that you'll always strive to reach the top of your mountain and be the best that you can be. See you next week.